Back to the Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a pretty simple data set. We have sales rep, the date, what their quota and sales were for the day, and their actual sales. And our manager asked us to build a formula that will show how much the sales were over quota. Now, your first attempt at this might just be to take sales minus quota, and you come up with a number, copy it down. But when you show this to your manager, she says, no, that's not what I want. I don't want to see the negatives. If they didn't meet their quota, I just want a zero there. Well, there's two ways to go about this. The first way is the if function. The if function requires three arguments. The first argument is a logical test. And in that case, the test would be, are the sales in D greater than the quota in C? Put a comma and then put the calculation to use. If that's true, we want to take sales minus quota. Otherwise, put another comma, put a zero, and enter that, copy it down. Now all of the negatives are gone. We only see the numbers that are greater than zero. The if function is the traditional way to solve this, but if you're a math guru, you'll recognize that the max function can also be used. When we had the original formula of D2 minus C2, some of the numbers were greater than zero and some were negative, and we want all the negatives to go away. So if I use the max function, equal max, and I put in that calculation, D2 minus C2, and also put in the number zero, it will look at both of those calculations. If the number's positive, I get the positive number. If the number's negative, well, zero is larger than it, so the max returns that answer. When you get right down to it, entering the max is much faster than entering the if statement. And so if you ever have this kind of a problem, you can use the max function or the if function, whichever you prefer. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another podcast from Mr. Excel.